Landowners and producers across the Great Plains are restoring a natural process to the land, one that allows them to increase grazing, boost cattle gains, and control problem vegetation. It's an ecological process that has been around since the beginning of the prairie. It's fire. While fires around populations or structures can be devastating, frequent fire on the open prairie is part of the Great Plains history.
Of course, everybody knows how big the Flint Hills was and how big the Osage Hills was and how big the tall grass really was in the beginning. It was huge and it shrunk way down. And so what's left of it, fire is very, very important in keeping the prairie a prairie and keeping ranchers grazing on the prairie.
Fire is an inexpensive and effective way to increase profitability. Prior to European settlement, fire was common on the Great Plains. Many wildland fires were caused by lightning strikes, especially during droughts. But Native Americans also used fire extensively for many uses, including to manage the land and aid in hunting. Researchers estimate that prairie fires occurred every 1 to 3 years in the south and every 3 to 5 in the north. Fire was so frequent that plants and animals adapted to it. Today, the prairies still wait for fire. Landowners are using prescribed burning or a controlled fire lit under specific weather conditions to return the Great Plains to what they were.
We do prescribed fire burning for grazing, improved grazing, wildlife habitat improvement. Killing cedars would be the main thing.
The suppression of fire in the Great Plains has resulted in an explosion of nuisance plant species, the biggest one being eastern red cedar and other junipers. Many plants on the prairie can resprout from their roots. Even when fire destroys the vegetation above ground, new growth can reappear within weeks. Not for cedars. A cedar killed by fire cannot resprout. New cedar plants must return by seed.
In Lincoln County, which we live in, is so heavily infested with cedar, red cedar. And we felt like if we was going to ever get them under control, we were going to have to apply fire.
Cedar trees are predators on the prairie, consuming valuable resources from cattle producers. Up to half of all rainwater is intercepted by the tree canopy before it hits the ground. Grass and forbs are shaded out by the spreading canopy, or kept from growing by noxious chemicals emitted by these trees, reducing available forage and the carrying capacity of the land.
Unburned areas, we've run anywhere from 10 to 12 acres per cow-calf pair. And in some instances, you know, where the canopy is up to 40% to 50%, where, you know, it's going to take us 15 acres. By applying prescribed fire on our ground, we can reduce those acres down to about 8.
On this piece of ground back here, we have actually almost doubled our stocking rate. We went from the 65, almost 70% canopy to what you're seeing now in the background behind us.
By putting prescribed fire on there, we can reduce that from anywhere from $75 to $100.
While mechanical shearing and chemical treatments are also used to control cedars and other trees, fire is less expensive and more successful over the long term.
Mechanically shearing is effective also, but you have that regrowth of trees within, you know, 2 to 3 years after you shear them off.
Clearing cedar through cutting frequently leaves seedlings and portions of trees. These remaining trees take advantage of the open canopy and continue to grow.
Chemical-wise, we're looking at anywhere from $300 to $500 an acre to try and chemically kill anything. And their success rate on these bigger trees is very, very small.
I can do this for $15, $20 an acre. It's just a cheaper way of maintaining our land.
It's actually less than to improve an acre of farm ground.
Fire does more than just kill unwanted plants. It also allows the prairies to bloom. After a fire, soil nutrients such as nitrogen and phosphorus become more available to plants. The exposure to the sun and the black ash causes the soil to heat up quicker, allowing more seeds to germinate. Even the smoke, which most people consider a nuisance, can also increase plant germination in some species. And since fire rarely burns everything, the mosaic pattern left on the landscape increases plant diversity. Using fire results in more palatable and nutritious regrowth for cattle and other grazing species.
Fire has been used from a perspective of annual use for a lot of years. You can go back and look at some historic documents of when cattle came up from the south. The Texas Cattlemen's Association and a lot of those contracts actually required those pastures to be burned annually, and that would have been, you know, in the early 1900s.
What we use fire for in our part of the country is multi-purpose. Mainly in our business, we do it because we want to get extra weight gain on the cattle that come through this part of the country before they go to feedlot.
Cattlemen in the Flint Hills of Kansas have been using fire to increase cattle gains for generations.
The average steer or heifer turned out on pasture land in the summer on burned grass will gain approximately 25 pounds per head more than they will on unburned grass.
Cattle performance certainly for about a 90-day period is going to improve by as much as 0.2 to 0.3 or a little over pounds a day additional gain.
And if you do the math, you take a steer that weighs 800 pounds, that's 25 pounds more at today's market, that could be $35 a head.
You just can't get around that. And so if you're selling pounds of beef off of acres, burnt grass is just worth that much more.
And fire can benefit more than just cattle producers.
I do it for wildlife, maybe to help quail. I figure if I can get enough land burnt back to native ground, bring some more food out, maybe they'll come back.
The return of native plants also brings back native wildlife.
There's prairie chickens moving back in, a number of shrubs that they haven't seen in quite a while. They are seeing some changes in the actual wildlife populations in these areas.
Getting rid of the cedar trees like we are now, we are reintroducing the mule deer population back in there to where the whitetail have pretty much taken over in this area. We're getting a lot more pheasants and quail back in this area. The turkeys are booming.
Whether it is cattle production, lease hunting, or just a return to a historically accurate landscape, fire can be a great benefit to producers and landowners.
The benefits are just numerous, you know. They so far outweigh any negative impacts.
This may not be the only tool for brush management, but it is the best one that we've got right now and the most cost effective of anything that we're doing.
My only complaint, I guess, is wish we could have got started sooner.